In a village, two friends were very close. They have been helping each other since childhood. The two started doing business together. They set sail for getting the cargo of their trade. But in the middle, a gust of wind began to blow. All the cargo and all the people on the ship were scattered and washed away. The two friends were also lucky enough to be swept to a nearby island. The whole island is also desolate. They are helpless there. The two of them also came to a decision. Let us both do penance here. They thought that if we saw God, then would ask what we want. Okay, the two of them sat separately far away in the shade of different trees and started penance. For one of them, after one day he became starved. Due to that, he thought it would be nice to have something to eat. Within no time, he began to smell the sweetness of good food recipes. The meal was ready there with all his favorite dishes when he saw with his eyes open. He wondered what the heck this tree was all about and ate it clean without thinking about his friend thinking that it is his credit. When the meal was over, he wondered if he had found after such a great meal if he had a better place to rest. Within no time the best bed appeared there. He lay on the bed and thought it would be nice if he had a lady to serve him to relieve his leg pain. As per his wish, a lady appeared and began to serve him. Then, he thought, hey, it's good, but if there is a big ship, I can get out of here with my lady companion. Immediately a ship appeared there. He was so happy that he took his whip and climbed into the ship and did not want to tell his friend to come either. Thinking that my friend did not deserve to climb in because he was not lucky enough. Hoisted along with the girl. Meanwhile, there was a loud thunderous noise from the sky. A voice was heard flashing. Why, you left your friend. Then, he was surprised and said that he did not deserve to be in it, so only left him there alone. Again the voice was heard from heaven that you should always be grateful to him. He asked why I should be grateful to him. Because he was the only one who prayed, God, answer whatever my friend prays. Every wish that is fulfilled for you and also the fortune you have now is only because of his prayer. Shocked with these words from the heaven talk, he immediately went to his friend and thanked him with joy and gratitude and begged him to pardon the mistake, and thanked God for bestowing with this friend who cared so much about him. There are three sorts of individuals on this planet. The first class of individuals hurt or disregard even the individuals who love them. They have a heart that beat tenaciously yet at the same time can't feel. They are visually impaired and dead to all love and care that has appeared to them. They are unequipped for appreciation. They are plague and illness to the Mother Earth. Never be one among them. The second class of individuals are the individuals who care just for individuals who love them. Their affection is narrow-minded and extremely restricted. Their adoration keeps going just as long as the other persistently cherishes them and plays their tunes. They utilize individuals and furthermore willing to utilize as long as it is helpful to them. Be aware of yourself to check whether you are one among them. The third classification of individuals are actually a gift. They love even the individuals who hurt them. They consider them to be couriers of God to show them some profound otherworldly exercises on sufferings, pardoning and so forth. Life is eventually a journey to know oneself. The individuals who hurt you are uncovering your deepest feelings of outrage, disappointment, venom and so on. Since just that which sneaks inside comes out when incited. So be humble enough to see the reality of what you are. Be appreciative to them for removing your awful karmic obligations and purging you. We have reached this stage in our life due to the help and cooperation of many people without even knowing it, for our growth in our life. Our mother, who is very close to us as soon as we are born and cherishes us, hoping for our well-being for the rest of our lives. Our father, who is constantly striving to nurture us, our siblings who wish and pray for our well-being, our life partner who constantly prays for our well-being, our friends who are behind us and help us unselfishly and keeps us in their prayers. With the help of so many, we are like this now. So when we spend our morning time with God, let us choose a person for the day and pray for their well-being. It becomes a good deed for us and is a worship force for them.
Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Press the bell icon for notifications. Thank you.